Paul de Chimday, Sieur de Maison Neuve, February 15, 1612, September 9, 1676, was a French military officer and the founder of Montreal in New France. Early life. Maison Neuve was born into the aristocracy in Neuville-sur-Avon in Champagne, France. He was the son of Louis de Chimday, seigneur of Chavagne, Germanoy and Brie, and his second wife Marie de Tomelin, the daughter of Jean de Tomelin, a king's counselor and a treasurer of France in the Generality of Champagne, and of Amboise. Paul de Chimday grew up in the manor house at Neuville-sur-Avon, not far from the Maison Neuve, Vienne, Maison Neuve Fief, which his father acquired in 1614. He had two sisters and one brother. He began his military career at the age of 13 in Holland, where he also learned to play the lute. He had a successful career in which he was noted for his ability and his honesty. At the age of 30, he was hired by Jérôme Le Royer de La Dauversière, who was head of the Société Notre Dame de Montréal. Royer de La Dauversière had a vision that inspired him to build a society mission on Montreal Island in New France. Maison Neuve was hired to lead the colonists and ensure their safety in the new land. Governor of Montreal. In 1642, Villemarie was founded on the southern shore of Montreal Island, where a chapel and a small settlement were built. A hospital, under the command of Jean Mance, was also established. Maison Neuve was the first governor of Montreal. The settlers maintained peaceful relations with the Algonquin people, one of the indigenous tribes of the area. The first year of the colony's existence was peaceful. In 1643, a flood threatened the city. Maison Neuve prayed to the Virgin Mary to stop the inundation, and when it abated, he erected a cross atop Mount Royal. A cross has been maintained there to the current day. Of the local First Nations tribes with whom these French settlers had contact with, the Mohawk, who were already trading with the Dutch and English in New York, resented French efforts to interrupt the trade. The Mohawk were based in present-day New York State, south of Montreal, and severely threatened the new colony. The Algonquin, in contrast, maintained peaceful relations with the newly arrived Europeans. Nevertheless, they were often at war with the Haudenosaunee, who only discovered the existence of the new French settlement of Montreal, whose defense Maison Neuve commanded using his military training, in 1643. Already familiar with the terrain, the Haudenosaunee would often observe and engage the French settlers from the safety of the woods. A devastating strategy. This was the beginning of a long conflict between the two groups as they were competing with each other for game and other resources. On March 30, 1644, the situation came to a head. Warned by their guard dogs as to the nearby presence of their enemies, a band of 30 settlers went into the forest to face their foes. Once in the woods, the French encountered 250 Haudenosaunee people in ambush, waiting for them. Retreating in the face of such uneven odds, De Maison Neuve remained last so the others could make it safely back to the fort, resulting in him being set upon by a Haudenosaunee chief. In this decisive moment, De Maison Neuve fired twice on the chief, thus killing him with his bare hands, as is sometimes quoted about the event, before returning to the safety of the fort amid much fanfare. In 1645, Maison Neuve received news that his father had died, and he returned to France. While there, he was offered the position of governor of New France, but turned it down, wanting to continue his leadership of Villemarie. Maison Neuve returned to Montreal in 1647, and the wars with the Iroquois continued. In 1649, Maison Neuve stood as godfather for the first white child baptized in the colony. She was Pauline Hébert, the daughter of the fur trader Augustine Hébert and his wife Adrienne du Vivier, who had come to Montreal in 1648 with Maison Neuve and their elder daughter Jean. In the spring of 1651, the Haudenosaunee attacks became so frequent and so violent that Villemarie thought its end had come. Maison Neuve made all the settlers take refuge in the fort. By 1652, the colony at Montreal had been so reduced that he was forced to return to France to raise 100 volunteers to go with him to the colony the following year. If the effort had failed, Montreal was to be abandoned and the survivors relocated downriver to Quebec City. When these 100 arrived in the fall of 1653, the population of Montreal was barely 50 people. They included Jacques Archambault, who dug the first water well of the island in 1657, at the request of Maison Neuve. Over time, the colony grew in size and eventually was large enough to be secure from the Haudenosaunee threat. Control of the colony was taken from the Missionary Society and taken up by the Crown in 1663. Maison Neuve had not enjoyed the favor of the new Governor-General Augustin de Saffré de Massy. In September 1665, Alexandre de Prouville, the lieutenant general of Montreal, ordered Maisonneuve to return to France on indefinite leave. After 24 years as head of the colony, he left Montreal for good. The later years. Settling in Paris, Maisonneuve lived in relative obscurity. In 1671, he welcomed Marguerite Bourgeois at his home in Paris. With his encouragement, in 1657 she had established the Congregation of Notre Dame of Montreal, an order of teaching nuns, who educated French and indigenous children. Maisonneuve died in 1676. At his bedside were his young friend Philippe de Terminis, and his devoted servant Louis Finn. On September 10, his funeral took place at the Church of the Fathers of the Christian Doctrine, situated not far from the Abbey of Saint-Étienne-du-Mont. He was also buried there. Honours. After his death, St. Paul Street in Montreal was named after Maisonneuve, who had built his home in 1650 on the early street. Nuns Island was once called Île Saint-Paul in honour of the founder of Montreal. The current name of the island appears starting from the 19th century and was exclusively used from the 1950s on. The Maisonneuve Monument was erected in 1895 on Place d'Armes in Old Montreal, to his memory. It is the work of Louis-Philippe Hébert, 1850-1917. An imaginary model was used to represent Maisonneuve, as no authentic portrait exists of the first governor of Montreal. De Maisonneuve Boulevard and Rue Chambet in downtown Montreal are named for him, as are Maisonneuve Park, the College de Maisonneuve, the neighborhood of Chambet and Laval, and the Maisonneuve Pavilion, a dormitory at the Royal Military College Saint-Jean. Gallery. See also. French colonization of the Americas. Timeline of Montreal history. External links. Biography at the Dictionary of Canadian Biography online. La Pratique du Luth en Nouvelle France par Paul Chambet de Maisonneuve, 1612-1676, Premier Governor de Montreal, Web Robert de Rome, Professeur Honoraire d'Histoire de l'Art, Université du Québec à Montréal. Novels. Lisa Boucher-Morency, Gaëtan Breton, La Perlouse Fondation de Villemarie, Book with Musical CD, Édition Planète Rebelle, Link, 1, 2017.